Good afternoon and welcome to Happy Christian. This is your pastor Mariana. This is a new day, a bright day here in the Netherlands. We are so happy that we can share with you this afternoon what the Lord is laying in our hearts. Actually, it's this morning I saw it in a revelation. The Lord has a purpose. He has a plan for somebody listening to this message today to bring you into success, to bring you into advancement. I'm talking to you about how to succeed in life, how to succeed at everything you are doing according to God. I saw a revelation this morning. I was in a place where a group of people were going down to the hill and another group of people were going up to the hill. Just a revelation. And I was praying and I'm asking the Lord, what does it mean? A group of people are very happy, but they are descending down the mountain. And another group of people are also happy, but they are using more effort and energy, and they are going up the mountain. Then the Lord said, you see those two groups of people, they are a picture of those who want to go up in life, they have to mount. And those who are thinking that they'll be taken up in life without mounting, they will just be descending. And Christians, people of God, I'm coming to you with this message today that if you want to succeed in life, you have to start mounting. As a church, as a worker, as a Christian, as a wife, as a father, as a husband, as a prayer warrior, in every level of life where you are, the Lord is calling on Christians these days to start mounting up to the mountain of God. What does it mean to mount up? It means you need to put more effort. It means you need to put courage. You need to put focus, energy, strength, time, determination, zeal when it comes to the things of God and when it comes to your own life if you want to advance and you want to succeed in life. You know, there's a passage in the Bible in the book of Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. We all know this passage. It's a very encouraging passage, but it is coded. So I want to decode it to you this afternoon. The Bible says, but they that wait upon the Lord, they shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. As a new believer, when you hear those that wait upon the Lord, you will think it is for you to just sit down and pray and wait. You will think it is just for you to wait somewhere for the Lord to do everything. But this decoding I'm bringing to you this afternoon is to tell you that after you have prayed, while you are waiting, you need to renew your strength. You need to encourage yourself. You need to make your strength double to begin to mount with God. And that is what the Lord is saying. While you are waiting on the Lord, those that wait upon the Lord after you have prayed, you need to renew your strength. You need to mount up with wings as eagle. There's a difference between an eagle and a chicken. An eagle flies above the mountains and the chicken is just on the floor. That's why we eat it all the time. But an eagle is not easy to get in touch. It's not easy to touch the eagle because it flies above. That's why the Bible talks about it in Deuteronomy. You shall be above only and you shall not be beneath. You shall be the head and not the tail. You shall be the first and not the last. People of God, you want to succeed as a Christian. You want to be a happy Christian. You want to be ahead. You want to move forward. Stop descending yourself. Stop standing in the same position. Stop holding hands together and coming down. We are talking about that gossip. We are talking about that wasting of time. We are talking about that time that you have put in climbing a mountain that you are using to descend the mountain. Realize it is the same amount of time. Realize they are doing, all of them are doing something. But something that has to produce is something that you put an effort on. put an effort, put strength, put time, put determination, put zeal, put your heart in everything you are doing for yourself and for the Lord. Then you will realize that mounting and climbing is very rewarding. As you are mounting, the Lord added, where do you end up? On top of a mountain. And when you are descending, you are still doing something, but you are descending. When do you end up? In the valley. Just get that revelation this afternoon, that whatever you are doing, watch very well and ask the Lord, Father, am I mounting or am I descending? Am I going up or am I going down in this business, in this work, in this prayer team, in this church, in this walking, in this school? Am I mounting or am I just descending? I'm repeating the same thing, because when it is a revelation, it comes as a rhema. And that rhema, God wants somebody to receive it this afternoon. So when you are a new convert, you hear that those who wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. You'll be thinking it is waiting on the Lord in your room or in the church. It is true, you have to wait upon the Lord by prayer. But while you are waiting for the Lord to work on what you have asked the Lord to do, the Lord will give you the strength. Look at it in verse 28. Just a few verses before this verse, the Bible says in verse 28, has thou not known, has thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainted not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. The Lord is at work. He works day and night. The Bible says, he who keeps Israel, he doesn't sleep, he doesn't slumber. In other words, our God is a hardworking God. He wants us to be according to his image, after his likeness. People of God, don't relent. Don't keep on doing something that is bringing you down. Whatever it is bringing you down today, the Lord will give you a revelation to quit that group and to join the group that will mount you up in the name of Jesus. You will quit the group where people are going down together, and you will join the group where people are going up together. That is the will of God for you today. In this year, you are going to change group. In this year, you will join the group of people that are going up, and they will end up on top of the mountain. That is the will of God for you, and that is my prayer for you. In the name of Jesus. Look at verse 29. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases their strength. So when you know that this group, you are using some effort with this group, and it's just bringing you down, you have to make a shift. You have to shift. And when you shift, you will ask the Lord, Lord, give me the strength to meet up to the pace of those that are mounting, because you need strength, because you need energy, because you need power. The Lord in verse 29 says, he giveth power to the faint. If you think you are faint, that is why you are descending. The Lord is promising to give you strength. He will give you power. The Lord is promising to give you power. If you think you are weary or you need strength, that is why you are joining the group of those that are fainting or those who are descending. The Lord is saying in here in verse 29 of Isaiah chapter 40, and to them that have no might, he increases their strength. The Lord is going to increase your strength so that this year, as the Lord God of Israel is alive, you are going to mount. You are not going to descend. You will be on top and you are not going to be beneath. You will be above and you will not be beneath in the name of Jesus Christ. Keep on climbing, keep on mounting. With the help of the Lord your God, you are going to succeed in Jesus' name. That is the only path to success is the path that you are mounting. Look at it in the Bible. Moses mounted Mount Sinai and he came down with the table of the laws. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord who made the heaven and earth. This morning I was reading this new Bible. I just bought a Dutch Bible. I love this Bible now. It is Bible in gewone taal. That means Bible in a normal language in Dutch. This Bible has a lot of revelation. If you haven't gotten it and you're a Dutch speaker, please get this Bible. It's a very good one. It's a very good Bible and it speaks to you in the way that you understand. Hallelujah. So as I was reading it by the grace of God, I will start from Genesis. So there are so many codes here that I read and I read and I read, and the Lord keeps speaking to my spirit, telling me more about a lot of things. But the one I want to share with you this afternoon also regarding getting close to God is this one here in Genesis chapter 3, verse 8. And het eind van de middag begon er een fris winterweer. God liep door de tuin. God comes to you with a fresh breeze. When we talk about the breeze of God, the freshness of God, the presence of God, you need it. As you are waiting upon the Lord will visit you with a fresh presence, with his fresh anointing, with his fresh glory. And when the Lord comes to visit you, you should be available. You should be ready to receive the Lord. And when you receive the Lord, he will fill you with his anointing, with his power, with his strength, with his glory. And when you receive that, you begin to mount, and you will continue to mount until you get to the top. That is the will of God for you this afternoon. Hallelujah. I will not be long today, because last week I had a very long video. This week I want to make it a bit shorter so that you should watch all of it. Watch all the video, and I know that the Lord, our God, is going to speak to your spirit, going to speak to your heart about that shift I'm talking about. You need to shift this year. If you know that the group you are with is the group that is descending, please change shift. Change your group and go to a group that will bring you up together with the people that are going up, that are determined to go up. So the Lord bless you. This is your Pastor Mariana. I love you with the love of the Lord. I really want you to succeed. People of God, I want you to succeed. Because your success is the will of God. Our success is the will of God. God bless you. And I speak to you next week.